Wednesday, July the 22nd, 2009, and this is your daily dose. What did I want to talk about today? Well, today I wanted to let everybody know that the office will not be open until noon. I just came in to do the video because I have some cable satellite issues that need to be resolved before we go crazy on Cox cable. So they're coming out today. So the office will be open at noon. I've been able to keep my sanity. Thank goodness. Quality organic medicine. Always, always a good thing, especially when stress levels are high. But today, between 10 and noon, Cox Cable is going to come relieve my stresses, along with a little bit of that Mendo. Now, what I want to talk about today, before I get out of here to run home, is you're going to hear me talking about this tomorrow as well. It's called the Truth in Trials Act. And what this is, the Truth in Trials Act enables individuals facing federal prosecution for marijuana-related offenses to provide evidence during trial that the activities they were engaged in were performed in compliance with their state's duly enacted medical marijuana laws. The Truth in Trials Act is not about the merits of medical cannabis. Instead, the bill concerns due process and fundamental fairness issues for individuals facing federal prosecution. Basically, what this does is it establishes an affirmative defense for individuals who are authorized to use and/or possess medical cannabis in accordance with their state law, and it guarantees protection against unreasonable search and seizures by providing a mechanism by which any property seized in the form of marijuana will be returned to the owner for their exclusive medical use if the property is found to be in compliance with state law. There's some other things about this that we'll talk about tomorrow, but what I'm telling people to do today is please call our members of Congress, ask for our U.S. representative, ask for U.S. senators, both of them. But here's the number for the switchboard. If you call 202-224-3121, the first time you call, like I said, ask for your U.S. representative from your state. Second time, ask for one of your senators. Third time, ask for another senator. And tell them to co-sponsor Congressman Sam Farr's Truth in Trials bill. This was basically all sent out, part of the monthly ASA information. I would encourage anybody who's already not a member to sign up for their email alerts. ASA is Americans for Safe Access. For those of you who are familiar with me or for those who may be new, that's one of my number one goals, safe access to quality organic cannabis for patients. We're legally allowed to possess it. Some people just don't have the time, the health, or the skill to produce it for themselves. And there's patients out there like myself and many others that would be more than willing to provide them. We just have to be legally allowed to do it. All right. Once again, Truth in Trials Act. Go out, Google it, Truth in Trials. Read everything you can about it. Call your congressman. Call your U.S. representatives. Also, keep getting legal. Patients are coming in right and left. They're starting to understand what's needed. Medical documentation, which isn't that. If you have any questions, come into the office. When you call me over the phone and I can't look at you and I can't explain to you so that I know that you understand. We're getting too many people that are calling back multiple times asking the same questions. It's okay to be afraid and apprehensive. But to be honest, just don't be stupid. You don't need to hear something 3,000 times. If you need to do your due diligence, by all means, absolutely do so. But I'm telling you right now, it is a state-administered program. It is perfectly legal. And they do not send little blue-suited guys out with helmets on to come kick in the doors and raid your house to beat you up for being a medical marijuana patient in this program. I've been in the program now going on over a year. Just had a renewal. So I've yet to have a problem. I'm in the privacy of my office, blinds closed, so I have no problem being able to possess my can. I've had no problems with that. So I would encourage anybody who has a qualifying medical condition to get themselves legal. Nobody wants the court costs or the costs of the bonds for the possession or the paraphernalia charge. Why pay over $2,000 when you can pay under $500? And it's actually less than that. For those who didn't know, the last couple weeks, boom, the price, total cost now, $460. And it's cheaper than that first bond. So it's like a medical marijuana insurance card, basically. All right, I'm going to go home, deal with Cox Cable. Hopefully today you have a great day. It's Wednesday. It's hump day. Enjoy. I'm going to love watching the Cox Cable guy try to figure out what the volcano is his first time in the house. But everybody, enjoy the rest of the week. Don't forget, tomorrow we're going to be talking about this Truth in Trials Act. And when I get back into the office, for those of you who might be watching that have packets that were supposed to be arriving in the office, I did get some mail. As soon as I get back into the office, the lucky recipients in this packet will be getting a call. And there's four of you that are going to be getting that lucky call. So keep getting legal. Keep spreading the word. Keep educating and informing. And I'm just going to give you a quote straight out of straight out of 21 Qualities of a Leader. I've talked about this before. I just happened to catch chapter 3 where it talks about commitment. It separates doers from dreamers. And then here's a quote. He who has done his best for his own time has lived for all times. That's Johann von Schiller, a playwright, that said that. It's great information. As a matter of fact, I'm getting goosebumps. Getting goosebumps just saying it. He who has done his best for his own time has lived for all times. This was Wednesday, July 22nd, 2009, and this was your daily dose. For those who didn't know, football season's coming up right around the corner. Better recognize. Go Buckeyes.